Git is using the concept of branches to manage different possible branched out code-based snapshots. This is a convenient form of managing changes and is what we're all used to. However, in many cases, we're working on one feature branch. Meanwhile, we're told that there's a critical bug in production that needs fixing right away. Until today, my immediate reaction was, okay, let me stash my changes and let's go deal with this. This is, by the way, a good case. In the very far past, I'd find myself cloning the repo again on a new directory and working on the changes there. If you think about it, that's not a terrible solution. My changes were kept on disk with lower risk of misscraping them or losing them in the list of stashed changes, but it's not perfect. Let's see this in action. So this is me working on my project and I need to make a change. For the sake of example, let's just add a log debug line that says hello there. And that's my change. That's my feature branch where I wanted to make changes and then push them to production, but I'm still working on it. So Git status shows main.go has been through changes. I either need to commit them or do something about it. But now I want to switch to a new branch to fix that critical bug. So I'll use git checkout with a new branch name, and main.go changes are now appearing in this branch. I didn't do anything. I've made the changes, I've changed the branches, and the changes are still here because they weren't stashed or committed or have anything to do with the original branch. Let me switch back, and now what I can do is just git stash them. Now that they're stashed, they're no longer part of my changes, and with git status, everything's gone. You can see that in the colors of my command line. And now when I switch back to the back branch, you can see that the changes are not there. Let's add another debug log line to see the changes and being able to compare them between the branches. Back to dev branch, if I would like to see my changes again, the way to do that is to look at the stash list, and the last item was the one I pushed last. So on dev, adding CI fixes number one, that would be it on place zero. So I'll just git stash pop in order to bring the changes back. Pop just takes the one on top of the stack. I think you'd agree that's not a nice workflow. It's error prone and it's hard to do. If you do that constantly, there's another better alternative. So let's look at Git Worktree. Git Worktree apparently is a native feature within Git I wasn't aware of up until recently. And that allows us to manage different trees. It's literally saying manage multiple working trees attached to the same repository, which means I can work on different trees. I can work on different snapshots of the same code base without ever having to stash anything or commit it and being able to jump around between them. So here's how it works. We start off with some kind of a change. In this case, .env has been added to my git ignore file. I'm on dev branch. Now, if I want to make changes in my repo, what I do is git worktree add, and I can mention either an existing branch or a new one. Minus b, just like checkout, will create a new branch, and I can add the name of the directory where I want it to reside. So I'm in my root, the root of my project, and now I have a new directory that's called new branch dir name. That's not very convenient, but it works. If I go there, you can see that I have a new branch called new branchy. Vim shows that, the git status shows that, so we can work on a different snapshot of the code base, add changes. For example, let's look at git ignore and see that the original change is not here because I'm on a different new branch. And I can switch between them. I can go back up to my dev branch and look at the original code base where my changes will still reside. Moving up and down is not great. Let's fix that structure. The next option is git clone with minus minus bear. Bear is basically cloning a bare git repository, and that lets you manage a repository only for admin stuff. For example, you don't have .git, you're not allowed to check out stuff, there are no branches managed with the normal path that we all know. Let's git clone minus minus bear the same project, and now when I look at it, you'll see fatbot.git, as in managing the .git of a project, and you can see that the structure is kind of different. There are references, objects, infos, hooks, and not the usual files that we're used to. So I'm gonna add the first worktree, which is the main branch. And now if I go down to main, I can see the original repo and the status and everything still there as I'm used to. Let's add dev, for example. and see that I have also dev here with the files and changes made there. Under Worktrees directory, I can see the different Worktrees that I got using the CLI. So this is a nice workflow, but it's still not perfect. Let's look at an amazing plugin that we got from the one and only, the Primogen. So it's called Git Worktree, and this allows us one thing to integrate the commands that I ran earlier with the command line into Vim. But the better thing is that it integrates with Telescope. And with that in mind, we can configure everything within Neovim and then use Telescope to view different branches or Git Worktrees and then switch between them, create new ones, delete existing ones, and it works fluently. Let's see how I configure that first. So Git Worktree, first of all, I'm using Lazy. Check out the video above if you don't know about Lazy. I'm adding Git Worktree to the list. And then when it's there, there are two configurations for the setup and then loading the extension for Telescope. Once I have everything configured and installed, I've added two key maps, one for switching between Worktrees and the other for creating a new Worktree. Let's see how that works in action. I'm starting Vim from the root bare repository, and I'll run the shortcut for me, it's SR, which S is everything for Telescope and R was the only available shortcut. And you can see the different Git Worktrees in the list. Now that I have something, I can switch to it. For example, here's the dev branch or the Git Worktree that I've switched to. I'm making some changes, so changes made on dev branch, and let's switch to something else. For example, back to main. The change I've just made is gone. I didn't stash anything, I didn't commit it. It's still there, back in the dev worktree, but I've switched to main and now back to dev, and here are the changes. They're still ready to be committed, and that's the nice thing about it. Now let's open another pane and open a different branch within it. So on the left, I have Git Worktree for dev, and on the right, Git Worktree for main. Now that's amazing. I have two unstaged changes from two different branches working one alongside the other. That's amazing both for reviews, for noticing changes, for working into different things, for being able to compare. I do have the gdiff split, but having two things, one alongside the other, looking at the same code base only in different branches is quite amazing. So on the right, changes on main, on the left, changes on dev. What if I want a new one? Let's trigger that. I'm going for S capital R. You'll see that mapping in my changes. I will look for something that's not on the list. For this example, it would be called my new branch. And since it's not on the list, Vim suggests that I add a path. So for the path, I'll add some kind of a directory to store the changes in, and that would be my new branch. And there we go. Vim sees that that's called my new branch, and the changes from both other branches are not here. Let's add another comparison. On the left, I have the original branch I just opened. On the right, I have main, and let's open yet another one with dev. So now I have three different branches with the changes of each working alongside each other. Let's run Twilight for a second, just so we can focus on the code and see the comparison between the three. That's absolutely amazing. For me, that's refreshing. It changes the workflow and it allows me to do stuff I never could with the ease of running Telescope and switching between Git Worktrees. Lastly, let's take a look at a quick method to delete a Git Worktree. So Control D, that's a default configuration, comes with a plugin, allows us to delete an existing Worktree within my status. I deleted the Worktree called my new branch. So let's go to the list of existing Worktrees and see that my new branch is not in there. Okay, so if you get used to working with bare repositories and then changing through Worktrees as they're structured inside the repo, I think it'll give you far more flexibility than you currently have. If you're used to stashing changes and moving between branches, that's not really convenient. And the ability to compare between different branches and work on different Worktrees as they're being changed is quite amazing, and it gives you an amazing flexibility. In my eyes, doing these things is not just about doing something faster or quicker or maybe even cooler. It's not about that. It's about shifting the mental energy that it takes to work through changes and maybe shift your focus towards a bug in production, for example. But instead of having to invest time and thinking about how I'm going to change context, whether I need to stash something, remember that I've stashed it, instead of all of that, I can just quickly jump to something else through Telescope without even leaving Neovim. And then I'm right there. I'm ready to work on the change. So I have more energy. I didn't forget anything. I don't have to remember anything or put something in the back of my mind. And these things, they build up and they compound over time. If you can do things much more easily and faster and quicker, it just takes the mental load off. I hope this helps you as much as it helped me. And for me, it completely changed the way I work and the way I'm able to switch between contexts of different code bases. If you still don't have Git integrated into your Neovim environment, I suggest you watch this one right here, and I'll see you on the next one.